Lesser than has-beens that never were, welcome to the greatest circus on earth, the greatest league on planet earth, the fantasy football league, the no cheese fantasy football league. Going through the same things per the usual power rankings week. My hiatus is due to the fact that my kids have been sick. Work has just been completely out of line. I've just been getting tortured by life, just absolutely yammed on. DeAndre Jordan Lob City style. Here I am. If you don't like it, fire me. I don't care. Fire me as the digital creator, content creator of this league. Do me a favor. BMW can do me a favor as well by firing me. Give me a break. I cannot stand that place. I've seen some odd decisions being made this week. You all should apply for BMW upper management. Jumping right in. Storylines, a couple things. Scoggins is 1-9, one of the worst records we've ever seen. That I don't think it's all his fault. Hear me out. I think it's his anti-spoon feeding. Now, I don't think that I'm the Archbishop of anti. So I decree all anti. I allow it. I see it. It all goes through me. Pause. But Scoggins' amount of anti is quite startling. He doesn't have the lowest points in the league. He doesn't really, quite frankly, have that close to the lowest points in the league. I believe he's bottom five, right? He's bottom five, but I think he's like six. It's not reflective of a 1-9 record. As a matter of fact, per the ESPN No Cheese Fantasy Football League standing points four calculator, I'm out of traffic, all of you. Per the ESPN No Cheese Fantasy Football League standings points four calculator, lack of amount of stress getting on the interstate. I hope you wreck. Scoggins has 100 more points than Gault, right? Thank you. Aren't you kind? He has 100 more points than Gault. Gault has 5 wins, and I think is projected to be in the playoffs if he's not already in the playoffs. 100, that's 10 more points per week. So whether that's Gault spoon feeding carrying over from last season, or Scoggins has bore the anti, I'm not sure, but I think a 1-9 record for Scoggins is unfair. He doesn't have a bad team. He's got decent receivers, has arguably the best quarterback room in the league, has decent running backs, has a good tight end, has decent flexes. I don't really know. I didn't check the points against, but I would imagine he is the sperm bank of the league. Moving on, Scoggins, my deepest sympathies to you and your family. Grounds are probably not in your near future regarding fantasy football, but you can tell us the amount of deer killed. Andrew's bench outscored Evan's entire team. Was 7 points behind Alex's entire team and 8 points behind Skeet's entire team. My bench went completely postal. It's just a testament to the incredibly bad roster management skills that I possess. My drafting and talent acquisition team is incredible, but clearly my start sits are not up to par. Connor Calder on not being up to par on anything. Storyline number three, it's a tight league race, one of the tightest I've ever seen. Call no my Wells Fargo bank account on being extremely tight. I think off the top, we've got I think Cheese and Gary are 7-3, but Gary has a better, Cheese has more points. Alex, I think me, Alex, and Calder are 6-4, I believe. I can't think off the jump. Then we've got, I don't know if we have any 5-5s. I can actually pull it up with my trusty log. Number of phones, all of you. Let me look at the L standings. Let's see here. Yuck. Okay. Give me a break, dude. You gotta be kidding me. This has Skeet is number one. That's how long this has been. Skeet's horrid. He's just one of the worst. Okay. Yeah, this is just not correct information. I don't think off the jump we have any 5-5. Here we go. Cheese on my patty and Gary's 7-3. Oh, Alex is 7-3 because I think he's won like 5 straight. Coming right behind him, Paul's, is Calder and myself. It's at 6-4. We have 2 5-5, Skeet and Galt. And then Clay at 4-6. So as it stands, Galt, Clay, Evan, and Scoggins are in the Calder Invitational. I don't know. It's tight. I can also look up Scoggins' points against. By far and away, he's just the absolute dumping ground of this league. 12-09 against him. give me a break. Boom. It's pretty tight. Pause. But me, Calder, Galt, and Skeet are kind of jockeying for position. I think two of us will be in there. Two of us will definitely be in there. And as it stands, it's me and Calder. But 6-4. Let's see here. 6-4. How many? What's the points against here? Calder is leading the league in points scored. Dead clock is right twice a day. And then there's me with a few points less than that. And then Skeet and Galt kind of drop off substantially. So unless they go on a big scoring stretch, they're going to have more wins than Calder and myself. I don't see them catching up to Calder particularly, especially with his spoon shoved very far up his anus. But that's another conversation for another day. And the final storyline, Dan Campbell and Arthur Smith must have joined the Mile High Club and slept together because they finally come to their senses and use their first round picks. I couldn't believe it. I guess they finally decided they couldn't put Jahmyr Gibbs back in the bag after what he was able to do the other day. And then Bijan got 22 touches. I got almost 20 fantasy points. It's almost like drafting somebody in the first means they're talented. Moving on. Deontay Johnson, Derrick Henry, Zach Moss, and Jahan Dotson. Last seen being productive on a football field. All four of those players combined for less than 5 points total. Hi, man. Considering the complete outburst that my Calder and Cheese teams had, I'm giving us all a three-headed pause high man. We all broke 140, so great work on that. Us three, y'all keep doing great work. And guys, it's an emotional moment for me and my family that I still don't have to worry about getting low, man. Evan, we salute you. We salute you and your family. We appreciate your service to this great league. But you gotta hold this L. Second by the Dean. Evan with that look. With that look. He got really low. He broke his all-time low. It's really bad, man. It's real low, 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 low. Belly, 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 bro 16. Andrew's bitch, then scored 80. Evan, you appreciate your service to this great country. We thank you for the ineptitude that you possess, that we all, that none of us have to bear that level of garbage. The dumbest play of the week. I hate to say it. And not most people did correct starts and sits. I could easily do my entire bench as a start and sit, but I still scored 140 plus, so it can't really be considered that way. But Alex. Alex, Christian Watson is not a startable asset. He's not a startable asset. It's done. Stop starting him. You've got enough talent, enough spoon on your bench to where you don't have to start that man anymore. Please, do yourself a favor. Stop starting him. Benching Trevor Lawrence is my smartest play of the week by Evan, which is crazy considering that he still got low man. But that defense, them coming off a bye, that's just smart. And then he started, I don't even remember who he started, but it was somebody that was like, I'm not sure I would start him over him. Actually, I think it was Derek Carr. I think it was Levis who he started, which is, that's tough. That's clever. Nice move, Evan. Let's see what else. UPS level post, USPS level postal, Keenan Allen, Dak Prescott, CeeDee Lamb. All of them broke 30. Keenan Allen almost broke 40. It's just completely ridiculous. The mega egg layer of the week. You would think this guy would have been able to do anything, considering that he's got his favorite quarterback back when he was like wide receiver 7 at the end of last year. But, albeit, I let bygones be bygones. Marquise Brown, my brother in Christ. Uno momento, por favor. Having some technical difficulties. And now I present to you you think that's funny, YouTube? Who's the owner of Google? I need to have a word with them.
You're not that guy, pal. Trust me. You're not that guy.
The owner of Google, you're not that guy. Absolutely. And Marquise Brown, you're absolutely not that guy. Absolutely, unequivocally not that guy, pal. The biggest anti-spoon feeding, Jonathan Taylor, an abysmal 2.9 yards a carry. Give me an absolute break. Najee Harris putting a 20 nugget on me. Are you kidding me? He wasn't even considered the starter per Mike Tomlin. Yeah, he still put 20 on me. Very asinine, very spoony. Let's see what else we got here. I got the song of the week. This is one of my personal favorites. It's in regard to the New York Giants, the cesspool of the NFL, the laughingstock, the Calder of the NFL. Uno momento, por favor. Here we go. This is in honor of Caleb Williams. This is in honor of what's about to happen to him. This is for him wishing that he could go to a certain amount of teams when he gets drafted. Oh, you're going to go to one of these teams, and it's not going to be what you want, baby. Be careful what you wish for, because you just might get it all. You just might get it all. What you wish for, because you just might get it all. You just might get it all. Caleb Williams, yeah. You're going home, baby. You want to play for the Giants? You can hold that L, baby. To the place where you belong. They are 1-9, and you'll be their quarterback. You will carry the torch of ineptitude. You will carry it to another 1-9 record. You are so bad, Caleb Williams and the Giants. Caleb Williams Enjoy being a New York Giant. You asked for it, baby. Be careful what you win for. You are really bad. You'll be carrying that torch of garbage for the next 15 years. Wow, what an incredibly bad player you've become. What an incredibly bad organization you'll be the quarterback of. Power rankings week, baby. Oh, oh! Number one, the running back reviver. Gason, there's a time and place for everything. The spoon holds no yearly bounds. Grayson Goforth, number one. Are you kidding me? Number two, the finesse. Oh, wait, no, forgive me. The spoon wielder, Gary. His best player gets hurt and he only loses one game. And, of course, it's to the trash bag. But give me a break. The spoon wielder himself. Number three, I don't care about your win streak, Alex. I don't. Anti-Holics Anonymous, AA, the trash bag. Number three, the roster that no one can hold a torch to. Number four, you're not going to like this, Alex. Calder, the league laughing stock. Number four, leading the league in the points. The dead clock's right twice a day. Number five, Alex, the spoon Sasquatch. Give me a break. Let's see who else we got here. Number six. Number six, Clay. Spartanburg Regional Hospital. Clay reached out to my camp and asked what it was like to have injuries. This is what it's like. I'm so sorry, Clay. I'm so sorry for your camp's loss. Seven, the finesse fairy, Galt. Mr. Unless this with Calder, we'll finesse anyone. Not think twice about it. Number eight, Skeet Nasty, the cross-country cesspool, going to Vegas to spread his ineptitude of his fantasy, the seed of ineptitude, halfway across the world, 2,000 miles away. Number nine, Scoggins, the anti-king. And number 10, Evan, the low-score lunatic. Bless his soul. May God have mercy on his soul. And may Biden's IQ points somehow be higher than Evan's points. Godspeed, Spider-Man. Next, puns for the week. This will be puns of players who just aren't that good. The names will be reflective of that. Jahan Notson with his 0 points. 0 points. Trey McBride. Baby daddy. Anyway. Glock Purdy. Give me them points. Toilet Pollard. Phony Pollard. Whatever the name might be. Okay. Amount of smoke right there, all of you. Lack of death. Staquan Fartley. Say hello to my Kittle friend. Just a bunch of garbage players. Some got kind of spoon-fed, but that's neither here nor there. Finally, one more thing, and it's time to wrap up. No, Phillip Rivers. The most pathetic team performance is the Bills. It's time to put them in the conversation for the worst team in the league. I'm tired of Josh Allen getting a cop-out just because he's decent at fantasy. He's a terrible NFL quarterback, and I'm tired of it. The New England Patriots. I wish we would have left them behind in Germany. I wish we would have left them behind. No America on leaving behind assets in another country. The Saints. You need to kick Carr to the curb. No Urban Meyer on kicking people. It's time to let Jameis Winston take the reins and let Chris Olave do what Chris Olave can do. And finally, the New York Giants. I don't even have to go into detail about that. You got Tommy DeVito. You're happy because he cleared concussion protocol so he can play, so he can get dug out by another team. Give me a break. Stop it. If they lose to Washington, I'm out. And guys, that's it. What a pathetic league this is. You're all complete animals. You all honestly all need to seek counseling. But Yeah, I mean, y'all know what time it is, man. I enjoyed it. We got good matchups this week. We got, let's see. I can run through them real quick. Connor, Jeannie McCarthy on New Year's Rockin' Eve. I'm running through people real quick. Let's see here. All right, real quick. This has lasted much longer than I thought. That's the first time I've heard that. Let's see. Arthur Smith's Hate Club and Evan. Cheese and Skeet. Skeet needs the win, and Cheese would like to keep his distance. Calder and Alex, that might be the matchup of the week. Big matchup there. Gary and Scoggins, Clay and Galt. Clay needs the win, but that's another conversation. Really, guys, it should be a good week. You all get fed, but that's it. Y'all know what time it is, man. I appreciate everything y'all do for this great republic. Trash bag outie.